just like Christmas.
At the Dene Nation in Yellowknife, staff have been busy getting toys, puzzles, and other activities ready to send to remote communities affected by COVID.
If you have been in isolation, you will understand because, you know, it's long hours. Some people don't have any contact with anyone, and, you know, it's good for mental health.
Something the 150 people who live in hard-hit Colville Lake will appreciate.
My common-law, my two babies are positive. My baby's been up all night crying, so I had to carry him around, give him Tylenol, and, you know, you just got to deal with it and just keep on going to the next day. And
the federal government has sent Red Cross nurses to Yellowknife and asked volunteer rangers in several communities to help.
What they're mainly going to be doing is, you know, providing the transport, providing distribution of supplies. I think a lot of communities are going to need supplies delivered to people that are isolated.
But the territory's health minister says more help is needed from Ottawa, especially nurses.
We're at an awkward time with the federal government because of the election that was declared on the same day that the outbreak was declared. I think they understand the urgency and they have already provided some resources. We need more. They know that.
Yesterday, another community that tested wastewater found COVID in the samples.
The Canadian Armed Forces says it can bring in more resources from outside the territory if the communities request it. But for now, they say they're managing as people pull together to help out their neighbors. Juanita Taylor, CBC News, Yellowknife.